Welcome to my channel. Today I've got a makeup tutorial for you of a sort of elaborate eye look with a lot of tiny details. I don't even know if you can see it from this distance, but yeah. Basically my inspiration was summer turning into autumn, so I just translated that to items that I could easily draw in tiny shapes on my crease. So I went for sunflowers and autumn leaves, so yeah, I really hope you're going to enjoy watching this look. Before we start though, just wanted to mention, if you want to see more makeup tutorials with me, you can always subscribe to my channel. I do 2 makeup tutorials per week on Tuesday and Thursday. And then on Saturday I usually have some kind of random video of whatever else I could think of. So yeah, I'd love it if you'd want to subscribe to my channel and watch all of that. If you want to see pictures of makeup and also of my random daily life stuff, you can also follow me on Instagram if you'd like. I'll put my name below here for a moment. And now, without further ado, let's get started. This time we're immediately starting out with the eyeballs, well, the eyelids really, because I have quite big plans, so I'm just priming first. Okay, for the eyeshadow I want to do an ombre, and I want to have the autumn side on the outer corner, both because it's darker so it gives more of a lifting effect, but also because I want to do a tree in the autumn part and it'll just function as an eyeliner, tree liner basically. So yeah, that's what we're gonna work on. Starting off with a soft blue eyeshadow, and I'm putting it in the inner corner a little bit above my natural crease. Because I'm gonna do a quick crease anyway, so pulling it down would be pretty much useless. On the outer corner I'm putting a darker, more toned down shade of blue. Like really we're going from like the bright blue summer skies to more like the dreary darker autumn skies, which sounds kind of negative, but I actually really love autumn. Like, I love the autumn storms actually, and I love, you know, the whole autumn color scheme, including actually the dreary skies. So yeah, but I'm just blending it together with the pale blue. And towards the top, towards the eyebrow, I'm going to blend it with the pale blue shade, because this shade and blending it into my skin is just not going to work. And the eyebrow highlight in a very pale sort of off-white shade. Then I'm using this tiny brush and I wiped it off, so there's no product on it as of now. And just using that to blend the two together, because it's a big fluffy blender that I usually use, this just won't work because it's too small. Too small an area, I mean. So yeah, I'm just gonna do this exact motion for the next 12 hours until I'm finally happy with it. Doing a cut crease now with a concealer. Of course, you can also use a liquid eyeshadow primer, but my eyeshadow primer happens to not be liquid, so I'm using this instead. And I always do that with a very flat, very stiff eyeshadow brush with a rounded top, just because I feel like it gives me the most control. Lots of brands actually sell these brushes, lots of cheaper brands too, interestingly enough. I think mine was from Body Shop, I think, but I'm not sure because it's faded off completely. But yeah, just use whatever you prefer. Just blending it out to the outside because I'm not sure how I want to let it fade, so yeah, just make it smooth. I want to keep the inner corner quite pale, so I'm just applying the same off-white shade that I used on the eyebrow bone actually. Sort of, I don't know, compare it to like a very pale beach or something for summer. I'm going after a theme here, but I do still actually want it to function as an eye look. Out of corner I'm doing green, and I think I'm gonna mix in some orange. Also, by the way, I gotta admit it's something that I really used to struggle with. With like when I was going for a specific theme, to not overdo it. As in, sometimes in the past I would go for a certain theme and I'd really stick to those colors. And then I would end up with a look that really did show what I wanted to show in terms of theme. But on the other hand, it didn't really work as an eye look, because the colors just either didn't, you know, look good as an eye look, or they just didn't look good on me personally. So yeah, that's something to keep in mind. Then orange on the outer corner, and I do think I'm actually going to let it end quite sharply. Like so. eyeliner, I'm going to do dark brown, and I'm actually going to use a liquid liner for that. For the rest of the, well, everything I'm going to do in a moment. I'm going to use face paint, just because I have the most colors in those. Alternatively, you could use liquid liners all over, and otherwise you could use gel liners. But yeah, I don't have a brownie face paint that's dark enough to do an eyeliner with, or at least in my opinion, for my liking. I can't even remember the last time though that I used this particular eyeliner, so I really hope it hasn't dried out or gone empty somehow. Just occurred to me that it's a good thing that I actually did blend out the concealer downwards, because I wouldn't for the life of me be able to put concealer between the trees at this point. So yeah, if you want to do this look as well, do blend out the concealer downwards. For the next part, I'm going to use a nail art brush. You can also use an eyeliner brush, or if you're using actual liquid liners, then it's probably... Well, those usually come with a brush, so yeah. By the way, not to make it into like a book video or anything. But I recently actually finally read a book that isn't a horror book that I actually liked. I usually only read horror books. And by the way, I'm painting leaves, in case you're wondering what I'm doing. But it was A Bedtime Return by Richard Matheson. Which is sort of a love story, but it's also sort of... I don't know, like if you haven't read it before, it is kind of sad, but it's also a very beautiful book. And very interesting also from sort of a science fiction point of view. So yeah, if you're not really a fan of romantic books, but still want to read something sort of remotely romantic, I do think it's a very cool book to read. I gotta admit, I was actually looking for the movie that they made of the book, but I didn't have it on Google Play, so I sort of just read the book instead because of that. Still need to look up the movie at some point in time. I'm just going in with all the colors that people usually expect in an autumn leaf, which is orange, red and yellow. Here and there I'm also going to put some dots in the same colors, just to sort of, you know, get very tiny leaves basically. Summerside is going to be sunflowers, just regular sunflowers. I'm just putting an orange blush on my cheeks now, and I've already done my foundation, concealer, powder and contour just to save a little bit of time, because I feel like this is quite a long tutorial. But I am going to show you all the colors I actually use. Just using a pale gold highlighter now. By the way, if you do want to know the exact names of everything I've used, then of course you can always find it below in the video description in a list, including the stuff that I used off camera. First off, I'm taking a shimmery orange shade on the autumn side of the eyes, so the outer corners basically. And I'm putting a shimmery white shade, or white shade really, down the rest of the eyelids, and I'm also going to use it in my inner corners. Then I'm applying a brown pencil in the waterline. It's pretty much the same color as the eyeliner, the liquid liner. Applying a brown mascara this time around. I actually have my lashes tinted black, so I'm not sure if this is actually going to even make them brown, but at any rate, it's not going to make them darker, which is the point. I don't want to go overboard and apply falsies because I don't want to cover any of my work. Okay, so that was actually quite a challenge because I happen to use brown mascara so very often, not, that this one is like pretty much completely dried out. For the lips, I'm going to go for an orange shade just because I want to pull the orange from the outer corners towards my mouth as well, if that makes sense. Okay, then lastly some setting spray and we're done. Okay, here's the final result. Also, I wanted to mention this lipstick by Yves Rocher. Over top, like, it's pretty sheer, but over top of a lip pencil, it's absolutely gorgeous. By the way, it's a shade Rouge Vertige in 53 Satin. But what I really wanted to mention about it is that it tastes like candy, like the past candy, you know, like the thing with, like, in the little tube, and then you have to push it back and one piece of candy comes out. I think we all know what those things look like, but it tastes exactly like that. I don't know how, I don't know why, but I love it. So I just wanted to mention that. Other than that, that's the end of this video. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!